A couple of weeks back, we showcased a demo page demonstrating how to achieve smooth scrolling with a fixed header. However, one of our viewers encountered an issue. The content was getting hidden behind the fixed header, causing an overlap. In this short video, we will tackle this notorious problem with a simple solution. But first, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't already to stay updated on our front-end development tutorials. Let's begin. The HTML page starts with a header that includes an announcement bar, logo, and navigation. Below that, there's the main content of the page followed by a very basic footer. Our CSS file is also set with foundational styles for the page. Now let's move on to the header element, which is styled with a fixed position covering the entire width of the page. Then we added some presentational styles for the announcement bar and the logo. The parent div containing the logo and navigation is set as a flex container for easy alignment. The justify content property with the value of space between ensures that both elements stay positioned, keeping the logo flush at the left edge while the navigation remains on the right side. Next up, the nav element is also turned into a flex container. The gap property in this case is utilizing the clamp function to set a flexible spacing between menu items. Finally, the main and footer elements are styled. And this is what our page looks like, a straightforward layout, nothing too fancy, just a clean and simple design. Now let's shift our focus to the topic of the day. As we observed, the links at the top are connected to their corresponding headings. When we click on a link, the page jumps straight to the related part of the page. It's standard behavior. In our previous video, we explored how to enhance this scrolling experience by setting the CSS property scroll behavior to smooth. This smooth scrolling is commonly used on one-page websites. However, having a fixed element at the top introduces the issue of overlapping. In our scenario, the header is fixed in position, and when we click on a menu item, the browser takes us to the top of the viewport and halts, scrolling right there. As the header remains fixed, the content slides behind it. Let's demonstrate this by reducing the opacity of the header so that it's more visible. See that? The scrolling stops at the top of the viewport. However, this default behavior can be altered with the help of the scroll padding CSS property. The scroll padding is used to define padding within the scroll container, affecting how scrollable content is presented to the user. It helps in specifying the optimal viewing area of the scroll port, which is the visible region of the scroll container, and enables adjustments to this area to accommodate elements that are fixed in position. Similar to regular padding, scroll padding works as a shorthand for specifying padding for all four sides of the element. It accepts up to four values, defining scroll padding top, scroll padding right, scroll padding bottom, and scroll padding left in a single declaration. Instead of resetting all four sides, we can simply utilize the scroll padding top property since we only need to adjust the top side. Furthermore, for those exploring logical properties, there's a corresponding solution for scroll padding to consider. This CSS property is particularly useful when handling elements with a fixed position, such as toolbars, sidebars, or headers, which may impact the visible area within a scroll container. Also, it doesn't change the layout or scroll origin. It only impacts the viewing region to avoid any obscured content from being hidden behind fixed positioned elements. If you found this tip helpful, make sure to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting tutorials. Thanks for tuning in and see you next time.